Dr. Jose Luis Abreu was born in Venezuela in 1956, exactly the year I returned to Iran. He's so young. He received his schooling in Venezuela. His Bachelor and Master's degree in agriculture from the University of Southwestern Louisiana and State University Fresno. So he got his bachelor as well as in agriculture. Why? Because we happened to visit him in Venezuela, and we found that he had a very big farm there. Of course, he owned many buildings and other things. Let's not speak about it. And he was himself in the oil industry, but he took us to his big farm, and the beauty is that in the center of it, there was a round, green, clear part which did not have any plants, any trees, nothing. And he said that he is going to build the first fire temple in Venezuela at that part. Well, that has yet to come. I'll tell you later on. So, back in Venezuela, Dr. Abreu completed an MBA and a management at Rafael Urdaneta and U.R.B.E. universities. His Ph.D. research was conducted in ethical dimensions of management. Ethical dimensions of management, and those ethical things have made him a Zarathushtri. I'll tell you later on again. Dr. Abreu has been attracted to the Zoroastrian religion. Current director of Latin America Spenta University Foundation, and a member of the California Zarathustrian Assembly, of which we are a member also. In addition to other professional activities, Jose Luis and his wife, America, please stand up. And their two children, Adriana, which she is in Spain now, in Madrid, and the other person is, again, Jose Luis. And they call him Jose Luisito, because he's a little boy this much big. In August of 2000, he published a book entitled The History of Ethics and Its Zarathustrian Origins. Ethics and Its Zarathustrian Origins, things which actually his research in these things made him find out about the Zarathustrian Assembly some 10 years ago, 12, 12 years ago, and he got in contact with us, and he came and he contacted us, and he had his Sidrapushi here 12 years ago. And I may also add that at that time, America, his life partner, came and whispered something in Spanish. And he translated and said that she says she remains a Christian. Okay, a few years passed and she had her Sidrapushi. And now you know what? Now Sidrapushi is done in Mexico or done by her. Come on, come on. Let us see. Well, he has our professor has any friend of Zarathustra is a friend of ours. These are his publications. Is Zarathustrian approach to quality management, that is almost his PhD, right? Almost. The ethical thought proposed by Zarathustra the third. The fourth is the fire of Srausha. Fifth, the fire of Armeti in business management. The proposal of Zarathustra beyond religion and philosophy. This is great. The proposal of Zarathustra beyond religion and philosophy. The seventh is the Venezuelan experience with the Zarathustrian teachings. Many of us Iranians have lost all they had when there was a change of government in Iran. And he has lost everything because of the change in government in Venezuela. He had to leave himself, America, and the two children on a bus almost, and took refuge in Mexico. But the beauty about the Mexican is that they immediately knew his values, and he became a professor at the Universidad Autónoma de Nuevo León, Monterrey, in Mexico. And this Monterrey University is larger than our LAX, our LA University. It's larger than that. It's a wonderful, and almost as far as I know, it works 24 hours a day, right? Even in the night, the university is working. And he is also a guest professor in several recognized Latin American universities. He's always very, very busy, And today, he's going to give us a talk on the basics of good conscience, the Zarathustrian religion. Please welcome. Thank you. I may make a complaint against him. You know, when he told me that he forgot his suit when he came here, I said, okay. Then he was very clever to purchase this morning. And he has made me without my coat. Please.
And you forgot your coat.
Yeah, I'm suffering because of him.
Thank you. Can we? I'm going to show you some. Okay, first, I want to express my gratitude to the whole community. I feel like home here. I'm very happy to be here. Every time that I come, well, I feel overwhelmed by the expressions of friendship. I want to thank Baba, thank you, for taking care of us. Very overprotective, always taking care of me and my family. Thank you, and thank you to Darius, Babsi, and their children. Sharush, thank you for the you took us to lunch. Thanks for feeding us. Thank you for your friendship. I want to thank you, all of you, for coming. I know we could have more people tomorrow, but I couldn't program this for a Sunday. But we have time. I promise I'll come again. I understand there is going to be some initiation ceremonies today, right? No? Oh, okay. I thought there was going to be some. Anyway, this is a talk. Gila, thank you for your. Also, gave us some food. Thank you. And friendship. I'm getting overweight. Okay. This is something very related to initiations, because to the decision that we have made to become Zoroastrians. So I'm calling this the challenge of being a Zoroastrian. I take it very seriously. I'm not just saying, well, I'm a Zoroastrian because I have Zoroastrian friends or because I have a good time getting together. It's more than that. We may have good times when we get together. We can come on Sundays and chat, talk, eat. But that's not being a Zoroastrian. That's a part. We have to live in community, okay? But once we decide, it's a decision. It's nothing. It's not like okay, I have children and they have to be Zoroastrian because I am a Zoroastrian. It's we are talking about a challenge that implies consciousness. And this is amazing that Zarathustra called this message good conscience. He's talking about consciousness. This is a very, it can be, I always say, it can be as easy as good thoughts, good words, and good deeds, good actions. And it can go as complex as neuroscience about human behavior, about quantum physics. So for me, that's why I say it goes beyond religion. And I may say, I'm sure that this is the only message that is that complies with science. I haven't seen any other message in a religious way that meets science, that is science proof, that you can test it, and you won't find any flaws. There are no flaws here. I've been trying to find flaws for 12 years. It's a perfect system. And this is a part of the speech today. I hope I pressed the right button here. Okay, I like to point out half of the people in this planet, over 3 million people, 3 billion people, live on less than $2.5 a day. So we're here, and we are fortunate. We have more than that. I hope so. 80% of humanity lives on less than $10 a day. Okay, I'm trying to take these statistics because this is going to show you something that I'm going to present later. So the title is Our World. This is our planet now. The poorest 40% of the world population accounts for 5% of global income. The richest 20% accounts for 3/4 of world income. According to UNICEF, this is an international institution, 22,000 children die each day due to poverty. Today we're going to have 22 children die. And you may ask what this has to do with Zoroastrianism. We are going to see this later. This is in the Gathas, by the way. And they die quietly in some of the poorest villages on earth. We don't even notice this issue. $20,000 die each day. This is terrible. Nearly 1 billion people enter the 21st century unable to read a book or sign their names. They won't be able to read the Gathas. Less than 1% of what the world spent every year on weapons was needed to put every child into school by the year 2000, and yet it didn't happen. We have infection, we have diseases, of course. This is the root of everything, poverty. This is the root of wars, poverty, bad leadership. When we don't have educated people, they don't know how to choose. And this is one of the main principles in Zoroastrianism, choosing the right leaders, right, Baba? We have to choose the right leaders. This is in the Gathas. But how can people choose the right leader if they don't know how? They don't have the knowledge to do that. So the only way is through education. Every year there are 350 to 500 million cases of malaria, 1 million fatalities, 1.1 billion people in developing countries have inadequate access to water. They don't, sometimes we waste water, we waste food. We go to a restaurant and they give you more than we can eat. That's a shame. And yet somebody, someplace doesn't have anything to eat. They don't have water. They don't have sanitation. We have 2.2 billion children in this planet. And we have 1 billion children in poverty. Oh, I mean, the thing is that we have a cycle. If we go deep in the gathas, we see that Zarathustra talks about cycles. We have to, if we go into the details. And when we have a couple who are poor, they get together, they reproduce, and they have five children. They are children in poverty. So these five children, they grow, they get other, they get married or together, reproduce, and see the figures go on and on in this cycle. So we have here the priorities of our society, okay? In cosmetics, in the United States, they spend $8 billion in cosmetics. But when we go to the red letters, in developing countries, they spend for basic education $6 billion. Let's not talk about military spending. Military, $780 billion. And again, in education, six developing countries. So this is the picture of our planet nowadays. What is the cause? What is causing this? And what the hell this has to do with the gathas? Forgive my expression. We'll see it. Behind the increasing interconnectedness promised by globalization, they say, oh, globalization is good. It depends. These causes are driven by rich, by power, and by rich leaders, and by powerful leaders. These can be leaders of rich countries or other global actors such as multinationals, corporations, institutions, and influential people. They are the cause. In the face of this enormous external influence, the governments of poor nations and their people are often powerless. As a result, in the global context, a few get wealthy while the majority struggle. And plus, adding to this, there is corruption. Poverty brings a lot of corruption. So my conclusion, I don't know if you have the same conclusion here, is that we live in a chaotic world, right? Somebody thinks different? Is this chaos? We have chaos in this planet, right? Okay? At the present time. When we go to Zone 2, in the gathas, the choice of Zarathustra as the Lord and leader of the living world, I suggest that you analyze this zone, which was beautifully translated by Dr. Jafari, my favorite translator. Okay, I advise you to get this. I'm not saying that other translators are bad, but he's my favorite. What can I say? Okay, so this song, this message, has to do with all the statistics that I just gave you. And here, Zarathustra, he used metaphors as an instrument for teaching. And at this present time, this modern time, metaphors are used to teach at the universities. They think that this is the best tool for teaching. Okay, it was discovered by Zarathustra 4,000 years ago. Okay, as some other things. So we have, he portrays this. The soul of the living world lamented to you. Why did you create me? Who fashioned me this way? Somebody here is complaining. I am oppressed by fury, raping, outrage, and aggression. I have no one to rehabilitate me other than you. Lead me to true civilization. This is what this planet would say today. This is what our living world would say today. After 4,000 years ago, it's going to say the same thing. Okay, then the creator of the living world asks righteousness. Who is your leader of the world? Who can offer her civilization, nourishment, and strength? Who do you wish to be her lord? One who shall repel the fury of the wrongful. I think today we are making the same questions. Who can get us out of this? How can we get out of this? How can we heal society? So righteousness, as a metaphor, of course, replied, there is no authority in the world who is free from malice. This is what I think right now about, if you ask me about politicians in the whole world. Who can I choose when we have elections in my country, who can I choose? So, 4,000 years later, the question remains. Okay, had there not been one person strong enough among them, I would have hurried to this call. This is Song 2, Stanza 3. It's better for us too, the soul of the fruitful world and me, to raise our hands for the divine grace and ask the wise one, will there be no livelihood for the honest? Will there be no reform about the wrongful? These questions stand today. Right, Darius? Do they stand today? Somebody disagrees? It's standing today, fresh. Currently standing in front of our face. Okay? And this is also a game, I could say a game of metaphors that he's using. He was smart enough to know that presenting this in this way, I mean, Zarathustra presenting this way, this will remain forever. The gathas remain forever. Are standing still. The wise God, the knowing, spoke in a loving form. So you do not know any lord or leader who acts in righteousness, but were you not fashioned by the creator to look after the promoter as well as the settle? The wise God of one accord with righteousness prepared his thought-provoking message in response to the sweet plea made by the world. That means the gathas. Because with his doctrine, he is the promoter for those who wish to be protected. He asked, good mind, do you know any person who can help the mortals? Okay, so we are using another metaphor, good mind. So, Zarathustra became a metaphor. He died. We know that he died, but he is still here. His teachings are here, so he's alive here. So the question, we have the question, who can help? We are in this chaos, who can help? Where do we have to run to? Who can assist you, assist us to do this? Then the answer, yes, I do. There is only one person who has listened to your teachings. He is Zarathustra Spitama, wise one. He is prepared to proclaim the message through his songs for the sake of righteousness. Grant him sweetness of speech. He's saying now that, well, we have a solution, and the solution is in the Gathas. And according to my research, I met the message 12 years ago. I've been doing research. I have developed some systems to apply to management because we have a problem of leadership. We have my efforts, since I know about this, have been oriented to the formation of leaders. This is what Zarathustra did. He realized all of this chaos, and he was a businessman. Correct me if I'm wrong, Baba. He had cattle. He was a regular businessman, and he had employees, and he was producing incomes for himself and his family. When he realized his mission, his responsibility to the whole living world, so he started taking actions. And these actions got him into some problems. He got in trouble. In the Gatha, he says that he lost friends. He had to go away from his family. But he started asking for Ahura Mazda's help. And he had this idea to go to the people who were in power. Well, he was taking a risk because they could kill him, but he decided to do something, action. Because I see a problem sometimes, we think we have good thoughts, we have good words, but we don't have actions. And sometimes we have actions limited only to the family. That's good, it's good to have a good family. But this responsibility is not just the family. Zarathustra, he wasn't just concentrated in his family. He was concentrated in the system, in society. Okay, so let me continue here. The soul of the world cried again, am I to accept a powerless man with a feeble voice as my caretaker? I want a powerful ruler. Will such a time come when he will give me his helping hand? Well, here, this is if we take this to the present time, we can say, okay, I don't have power, I don't have money, I don't have too much resources, too many resources, so I'm not gonna do anything. That would be an option. So that's what they are saying. The world says, oh, that's just a man, what can he do? Just a man. He won't have an impact. There was some, you know, there was some doubt about this, about Zarathustra. God grant him and his people strength and power through righteousness and good mind, so that he leads me to peace and tranquility. I also always want to recognize him as your foremost discovery. Okay, there, I suppose there was some kind of talk, and then it was agreed that he was the right person. When shall righteousness, good mind, and the divine dominion hasten to me? Ways one, do acknowledge with your discernment the order of the great fellowship. God help us now. We look to your kindness. Okay, now here is very important, this paragraph here. Zarathustra is not here with us in physical, but he knew he won't be forever in this material, in the physical dimension. But he prepared the message to be taken by other people who would represent him. So, Zarathustra is the metaphor that we have to follow. We have to do what he was trying to do. This is the challenge. This is the challenge of becoming a Zoroastrian. We have to ask what Zarathustra would do, and then try to do what he would do. We have to think similar to Zarathustra. What he would do, what actions would he take? And these actions, they go beyond just meeting and praying. It's good to pray, it's good to pray to God, but we need actions. We need to change this cycle. We are in a cycle, very bad cycle. And we are stronger than Zarathustra. We are more people. He was one person. We should be stronger. He would like us to be stronger than him. He's not selfish. He's not jealous. He wants us to do the same he was trying to do. He won't get angry at that. So he left the legacy of the assembly. And this is the challenge, to assemble and to do this, to do what he was trying to do. And this was written by, I don't know, you know this person, by Dr. Jafari. Those used to physical force may not easily understand the power of mind. Zarathustra, he didn't have weapons. He didn't have too many resources, but he had a mind. We all have a mind. We have an intellect. We have a brain. We have to put it into action. The message is not complete if we don't action. We have to go into action. And that means beyond the family. It's important, the family. But we have to do something for society. So I was amazed when I found these little words, but big message from interpretation of Baba. We have this, the power of mind. This is our main resource. And Zarathustra, when he talks about Bohumana, that is good mind, he's talking about the power of mind, Bohuman. When he talks about Spentamenju, that's mentality again, progressive mentality. It's about using our mentality. When he talks about serenity, that means that our mind has to be stable. That's our best tool, our mind, our mentality. So we have to work on aramaiti, which means serenity. There is another tool that he used that was intuition, seraosha, through prayers. It's also important. I think it's central also in the gathas, meditation. We need to do meditation. Meditation, but also action. And for me, you don't have, for meditation, it's not just lying there doing nothing. Meditation can be related to doing things. That's a progressive serenity, progressive aramaiti. We can use serenity, but moving. And that doesn't mean that you don't get angry. You have to get angry at the right things. Get angry against poverty. We have to be angry in front of poverty, in front of corruption. How can we be happy, you know, with corruption, no? We shouldn't be happy about that. But it's a positive anger. It's good for action to do something about this. Okay. When I was in Venezuela, we had a good life, and Darius and Baba, they came to Venezuela during my research for my Ph.D. thesis. I found Zarathustra, I found his teachings. So I started digging, and I haven't finished. I might not finish during my lifetime. And they came, Baba told you about the conditions that we were in Venezuela. We have many plans. Sadly, it was impossible. Let's say that the plans have been postponed in Venezuela. Anyway, one of the things that made me go to Mexico, I had to make a decision where should I go? To which land should I go? Where? So we decided to go to Mexico, and one of my main concerns was that I was working in this Zoroastrian project. I was working in this Zoroastrian project, and I wanted to keep it alive like a fire. For me, that was like a little fire that I had in my hands. And I remember one time a couple of people representing the government, they came to my house because we started teaching in Venezuela. I remember Darius, I don't know if Abba came, and we gave diplomas to little children. We started teaching to children and courses. We had also a big graduation ceremony for a 6 months course that we had. And we had a beautiful fire during the graduation ceremony. We gave a 6-month diploma. And we invited people from other universities. And we started doing some work. It wasn't easy because some of my students would come to me and they would say, I love this message, but I'm afraid that I can go to hell if I follow Zoroastrianism. So I had to talk more to these friends. They won't go to hell just because they are practicing this. And one of the strategies was to present Zoroastrianism as a philosophy. Philosophy. We're teaching philosophy. and we are teaching a way of life. Okay, so that's that made these people more comfortable. They wouldn't go to hell because they have fear. They have been raised with fear. If they don't follow what they have been taught, they would go to hell. There is no fear in Zoroastrianism. We shouldn't be afraid to ask questions. The gatas is full of questions. The gatas is a big question mark. And we have to question. Questioning is the motor of science. No questions, if we don't have any questions, we don't advance in science. We don't advance in technology. So this is the only message that answers to science. Other messages, they fight science. Don't ask questions. Here we ask questions. And here we are in a learning process. And we are allowed to ask questions. So this is what Zarathustra is telling us. Don't be afraid to ask questions. And he says, Ahura Mazda, God is our friend. If I'm your friend, how can I send you to hell? I'm not God. And if I were God and I had the power, I wouldn't send my friend to hell. I wouldn't kill him. So it doesn't make any sense. So fear is out of the equation here, out of the Zoroastrian equation. So no fear. That's one of the things that made me become a Zoroastrian. Sometimes they ask me, why, how did you do this? Well, yes, I found this book on Zoroastrianism when I was doing my research. I like that, but really the book didn't make me become a Zoroastrian. I became a Zoroastrian during a process of learning from many, many different things, because this is a learning process. We don't have the answer to everything because, why? Because there is something that is called Spenta Menu. Things are progressive. Nothing is just steady. Things are changing. And we have to be prepared for change. During these years, I've been reading a few books. I translated the gatas into Spanish. Since I don't have a lot of money, I cannot have an inventory. I'm a man without resources. So that's why I'm using Amazon to have they print the book when people order. I'm not here to sell books, by the way, but this is some of the books that I have. I want to talk to you about I want to show you this because it shows how the range that we have for the message, the range of that can go from something simple to something complex. We can go like the philosophy of Zarathustra, where I talk about several topics, but I want to highlight this. I apply the message into ethical management. This book is being used in our faculty in Mexico because I want to make sure that people know about Zarathustra. So it's being used as a reference book. And this brain economics, the Spenta model, is a more complex. It's more difficult to understand. I have to accept that. I was invited by some German scientists to present this model. I went to Munich to present this. It says that finance doesn't depend on numbers. It depends on people, on human behavior. So the economics that we have is the cause of human behavior. And now is the result of wrong behavior, unfortunately. We have I have a book on Zoroastrian poems, and I'm talking about this because I'm going to give the assembly a set of books. I have a book on poems, and the first one was the history of ethics, and because not too many people think that philosophy and ethics come from the Greeks, but it comes from Persians. And even I found out that Pythagoras. All of you, have you heard about Pythagoras, right? And there is the Pythagoras theorem, you know? Well, that theorem was written many years before Pythagoras. And it was written by Persians. So this is these things that history doesn't show. That means that they are not teaching the truth. And my conclusion is that everything has to be based on Asha. If we go with Asha, you are fine. This is what Zarathustra is saying, Asha. Of course, related to other things, Aramaiti, Spenta, Menju, all of that, but Asha, we have to work, everything we do has to be within the frames of Asha and Bohuman. It's easy to say, but sometimes it's not easy to do. I think I'm learning to do that. I'm trying, we have to try to do this. And everything is in the mind. I want to present this to Dr. Jafari, these books, for my conclusion. There are so many things to do, to say, to discuss. So I think being a Zoroastrian is taking the challenge, to act like Zarathustra. Because the word Zoroastrianism or Zarathustrianism comes from Zarathustra. That means we have to try to do what he does, what he did. So we have to really try to take that position. It's a big responsibility. And every day we have to do something we have to act every day. Okay, it's not just the initiation. Some people never do, they will never perform an initiation, and they are more Zoroastrians than we are. So this is the challenge. The challenge is to behave like Zoroastrians. And to behave like Zoroastrians, we have to study the gathas. Study the gathas and put in action the gathas. I'm trying to teach this in Mexico. We have a student from Ecuador, Peru, Colombia, and they are learning Zoroastrianism, and sometimes they don't even know they are learning Zoroastrianism. That's the beauty of this. This is universal. Of course, I make sure that they know about Zarathustra, and they know what Spenta means, and they know the model. Okay, I don't want to put you to sleep. I want to I'm calling you about 10 minutes ago to come up. Thank you. Oh, if you have any questions, let me give this to Baba. Zoroastrian poems. So you can have available. Let me put it down here. Yes.
First is the Gathas in Spanish, Los Cantos Divinos de Zarathustra. Brain Economics, Spenta Model. The Philosophy of Zarathustra. The Zoroastrian Model for Good Business. La historia de la ética es su origen Zarathustriano. My Spanish is better than him. La filosofía de Zarathustra. All these books and the Zoroastrian poems. Zoroastrian poems. Let me read one, by the way. To choose, I have a right. Life is in freedom. It's the logics of wisdom and the manifestation of life. Do not stereotype about my religion. I have chosen the good dominion, and the wrong suppositions will not make me lose my Gothic vision. I am proud to be a Latin American. He says, he's showing me his fist. I am proud to be a Latin American, which won't stop me from being a Zoroastrian. I am on the road to radiant happiness, Ushtar, because I have chosen the path of righteousness. I may have a different culture, but the Gathas are still my nurture. I have a different tradition. Still, I have Ahura Mazda's protection. Who can stop a decision of the wise one? If it in addition I use my woman, certainly not a wrongful human, whose mind is in a dark swamp. You can spend time discussing, with wrong arguments accusing, continue wasting your time, just the same freedom of choice is mine. You can continue your conversation, but my choice is, freedom of choice is mine. Please read the Gathas to find that the decision is the only mine. There is no power in domains of wrong to keep me away from the house of song. Freedom is a special condition granted to me by the Lord of creation. Of authority, there is no other divinity that change, that can change this reality. That is one of the songs I just opened this. So, so here is our Jose Luis Abreu.
They may have some questions.
Yes,
if they put it down here, so if they won't fall.
So if you have any questions, please. This is very strange. Again, I say, Zarathustra is the only person, the only person to this date, that he has 17 songs, this much. 17 songs, and he has 93 questions in the song. 93 questions, which are its own answers. It is, and what we find in Haptang Haiti, it says, we have got the Gahambars. We have the Gahambars here. And the beauty about the Gahambar is that we take something from the Gathas and talk about it. And then there are questions and answers almost 4,000 years ago. And I remember myself when I had to ask a question from, a priest. He would say, Khafesho. Just be what? That actually you cannot.
Choke yourself.
Yes. Choke yourself. Just imagine. No questions. And here we had, just during Zarathustra's days, that the people stood and asked questions and they were answered. And there is nothing saying that the questions were by wrong people or something like that. It's a welcome thing. And again, we have in Haptang Haiti, which follow the Gathas, is that we should learn the divine message of Zarathustra first, which he did, practice it, and his practice was what probably changed America, his life partner. Practice it and teach others so that they learn and practice. Have you any, just this two sentences is in any other book? This is what is our religion, and here is an example what our Deen-e-Behi can do to every one of us. Here is an example.